Welcome to Nasdaq Trade Talks. I'm Jill Malandrino, Global Markets Reporter at Nasdaq. Joining me is Sara Baack, Chief Product Officer of Nasdaq-listed Equinix. Equinix is also a member of the Nasdaq 100 Index, home to the most innovative companies listed on Nasdaq. Sara, it's great to see you as always. Welcome back to Trade Talks.
Thank you for having us, Jill. Great to be here.
Tell us why digital transformation is rapidly becoming a board-level priority given the events over the last 18 months.
Sure, yeah. Well, digital transformation has been a durable trend as we've seen over the last few years, right? You know, companies like manufacturing leveraging IoT to help do predictive maintenance in their facilities, you know, to the wearables that we all have on our wrists every day, to so many different aspects of how we consume and operate life. All of those things have been, you know, sort of turbocharged with the advent of the pandemic, where when you think about now you're doing your grocery shopping online, now your children are doing all of their education online, we're doing telehealth online, we're seeing our doctors from, you know, sitting in our home offices, sitting in our bedrooms. All of those additional sort of changes that I think COVID has inspired are likely here to stay and have required so many companies to really figure out how to more aggressively transform their digital agendas to accommodate that, which is why boards and you know, governance over companies today are really seeing that as a critical priority.
What does the digital infrastructure shift look like? Because it sounds like it's not just about enabling business anymore.
For sure. I think infrastructure, you know, used to be thought of when you think about technology infrastructure in companies, I think that used to be thought of as sort of an enabler to the business. And now it's really the front and center strategic driver of the business. It's the source of competitive advantage for the business. And so I think that's really kind of put it on a different stage with a different level of priority, a different level of pressure, probably candidly, right, to be driving the front of house experience that customers that businesses are delivering to their customers.
Why is sustainability and corporate responsibility a key value driver for Equinix and its customers?
Well, sustainability has been, you know, a critical part of our agenda for many years now. As the world's largest provider of data center infrastructure around the world, we operate in 63 cities around the world with 220 data centers, which you can imagine are hosting, you know, all of the world's leading technology vendor infrastructure. That, you know, we've had a need to be a steward of the environment for quite some time. We launched back in 2015 a program targeting 100% consumption of clean and renewable energy sources to power our entire footprint. And it's exciting to be almost over 90% towards that goal. And that's kind of fueled us to launch an additional goal to really target getting to full carbon neutrality by the year 2030. And the reason that that's important for Equinix is that customers require that, investors require that, employees require that, it's good for public policy. And so all of the stakeholders that Equinix is seeking to serve are seeing that environmental sustainability as a critical need.
All right, Sara, appreciate the insight. Thanks for joining us on Trade Talks. I'm Jill Malandrino, Global Markets Reporter at Nasdaq.